Hey guys! So this morning I thought I would jump on here real quick with this time of the year rolling around with the holidays. There's just something on my heart that I would like to chat with you guys about, and that's something that I think most of us moms, Mimis, and wives struggle with, and that is guilt. Mom guilt, Mimi guilt, wife guilt. Taking ourselves first comes very foreign often to us as women. I'm not saying that that doesn't happen for men as well, but a lot of times as women, we're so busy trying to take care of everybody else. And especially this time of the year, I know we start thinking, our minds are thinking about Christmas gifts and entertaining families, in-laws, and family members for holiday food and get-togethers, and all this stuff starts piling up on our plate, not only to manage as far as time constraints, especially when you get to the season that my family's at with trying to get adult kids together with their schedules, and it just all becomes a lot. And the point I'm getting to here is, for me personally, this is the time of the year last year that I decided I was going to take my health serious. And that was really hard. I got on the struggle bus with that because I knew I needed to make some changes, and I desperately wanted to make those before the holidays because I didn't want to just basically add injury to insult. I didn't want to add, or however you say that, I didn't want to just add more weight. And I knew that if I didn't make some changes, then I was going to, because of the holidays, I would end up just gaining more weight that I would have to lose come January. But to make that leap into action from just wanting it, I was on the struggle bus, seriously, because all I could think about was, how can I do that? How can I spend the money when I've got all this stuff coming up, Christmas gifts I need to buy and food that I'm gonna need to do and all of this? Secondly, how am I gonna work that into my schedule because I'm so busy with my jobs and trying to schedule everything else? How can I add that to my plate? Like, it almost took my breath away to think about it. And I'm so grateful to a godly husband who stepped up and said, you've got to do this. You've got to do this for you. And if you don't have somebody in your life to say that to you, that's what I'm here for this morning. I want to say to you, you've got to do this for you. It's so important. And I'm so grateful that he gave me the push and the okay that I needed to make myself a priority in that season and to make the changes that I needed to make for my health. And I'm telling you now, on the flip side of that, almost a year later, it was the best decision I ever made, not only for me, but for my family. And I will tell you, as a coach, on my celebration calls, my 1 week celebration calls, my check-in calls, all of the things I do with my clients, I get to celebrate all the time mamas that say, oh my gosh, my kids are loving this mother that's up and outside playing with them this summer. They were outside and many aren't sucking wind, or they have the energy to even get up and go do those things, go on walks, play games, you name it. I have another mom just the other day that said, my kids are loving getting in the kitchen with me and making these lean and green meals. They are having fun and they're learning to cook, and they're learning to cook well. They're making changes, not only for themselves, but the trajectory of their family and those skills that they're handing down about how we handle life, because life's never gonna pull over and say, here's a perfect opportunity for you to change. We just have to pull up our bootstraps and say, today's the day I'm gonna make that change. I'm gonna take my health serious, not only for me, but for my family. And if you need somebody to tell you that that's okay, let me please be the one that tells you it's okay. Have a blessed day.